Welcome to this presentation about the FHIR messaging, which we are implementing in the healthcare system in Denmark at the present. We have a modernization project, and I will have a little briefing about this in the next 10 minutes. My name is Michael. I come from Medcom, which is a non-profit organization in Denmark. We are owned by the Ministry of Health and regions and municipalities in Denmark. My job is as a team leader for the standard team to produce the standards in Denmark, and we also as a test lab where we test and certify all the vendors for complying with these standards which we are responsible for. We have a dialogue with all the IT vendors in Denmark, at present 153, and we have a standardization talk with them about 194 different standards. We run a nationwide program where we have responsibility for the backbone healthcare infrastructure in Denmark for messaging, and we also facilitate a lot of implementation projects around in Denmark. Since 1994, where Medcom was established, we have made a lot of standards for referrals and discharge letters, lab orders and reports and reimbursements, all made in the EDIFACT back in the old days, 25 years ago. 15 years ago, we decided to modernize into XML instead of EDIFACT, but we chose to make some local national Danish standards instead of using some international standards. 5 years ago, we realized we had to change the strategy, and from 2015, we have had the strategy to migrate to HL7 standards all over. So standardization is a never-ending process. First, I'll say a little bit about infrastructure, and then I will get back to messaging with the messages. In Denmark, we have a national service platform which holds two very important paradigms of sharing data. We use an XDS document sharing for message types or document types as home monitoring, appointments, care plans, etc. But the service platform also holds a lot of databases for medication, for lab orders, for lab results, for results, and etc. These repositories are at present web services, but for the messaging paradigm, we have a privately operated network in Denmark, and we use addressing with the use of location numbers. In the very near future, we expect to migrate away from this old infrastructure and implement e-delivery, which is a European project where we can message across different countries, but also across different domains within the countries. So the trend we see is that we will have more and more sharing and less messaging, but we are very confident that we still need the paradigm of messaging. So these two paradigms will coexist also in the future. Here is a small plan of how we will how we see to implement this infrastructure with the old messaging in the bottom here, where we have some access points for messaging between, and in the central message hub we have in here in the middle. We will transform the FHIR messages to FHIR documents and load them into the XDS document sharing, where they can be used from citizens, apps, and solutions. For the messaging part, we decided to try during this year, 2020, to make our first FHIR messages. And we made some profiling of two messages. The first one is notification of hospitalization, and the other one is called care communication. It's a sort of clinical email where you, in a secure way, can send a short message about a patient. when we talk about messaging, we also have the need for a standard for an acknowledgement whether the communication went okay or bad. The learning so far is that if you have more standards or more versions and different technologies in parallel, it's very expensive. So it's costly for us with all our old legacy formats. We found out that transition from the old legacy is a complicated project. And we found out that it is a good idea to have a modernization infrastructure and also an modernization of standards, but they are not binded strictly together. We can modernize the standards without at the same time modernizing the infrastructure. We can do it whenever we choose to modernize. One thing we are absolutely sure is that we cannot never make a big bang implementation of anything. So in Denmark, we chose to make some profiling with this model where we have the international specification, and we make a Danish core, which I believe most countries do. That's where we have our national patient profile with the Danish patient identifier. We have a Danish community, which is organized within a special interest groups under the Danish HL7 affiliate. From this Danish core, we have a Medcom core layer where we have all the profiling that is common for all our different message types. And whenever it is in an actual message, there's a need for a specific profiling, we do it at the actual message level. But we'll do as much as we can at the Medcom core level. We make publication of our profiles from GitHub to the simplifier, which we use as a national repository for displaying all our profiles. We also have a FHIR server with the implementation guide. And we also have a FHIR server, which we will use as a terminology server. The notification of hospitalization, we have profiled with the user, the message header, and also with the message history resource. And that's because we need the provenance resource where we can reference between two messages in the scenario where we have to make some reply or forward of the message. Obviously, we need a patient and also an organization for the sender and receiver information. And then we have used the encounter, and we need the encounter because there's an episode of care identifier which we need to be a part of this message. A very important value set in this standard is a list of message activities, so we can evolve and add to this list without we having to make new versions of the profile. The care communication is another message type we have, but it uses the same message header, message history, patient, and organization. But we have to hold the subject and the text element from the email, and we first considered the use of composition, but we changed it for the use of communication resource instead. So we use the status and priority options or fields in the communication resource, and that's also where we make attachments, because we have a need to exchange a short message with a PDF file or some imaging attached. We have a category which we have profiled, so each communication is one of a list of known categories which the receiver used to distribute and sort and filter the received messages. Test and certification is obviously needed. We are certified ISO 9001 for testing and certifying, and we will expand that testing with the use of touchstone test tools for an automatic self-test. That's our strategy for testing FHIR. During the DevDays, you can find me or some of my colleagues, and feel free to ask us any questions about our strategy for messaging in Denmark. Thank you. And you can ask, why did it take us so long in Denmark to swap to international standards? And where can you find our implementation guides? Here you are, guys. Comments, please. Thank you.
All right. Thank you very much for your presentation. There are not any questions yet. You, right before we started, you were elaborating on some parts of your presentations. Maybe you want to do that now as well, so everybody can join in on your great ideas.
Yes, I'm not sure if it was just only my screen or it was a general problem that that the last the presentation was missing. The first six pages of the PowerPoint was correct, but I didn't see the sound was okay, but the last pages was not shown on my screen.
Wait, let me put it on the screen. You mean that it stopped at this?
Yes, at number six, that was the last one I saw. But I thought this the pages 7 and 8 could be very central because that's the actual profiling in FHIR standard.
All right, let me just skip to that page then. You mean these pages, right?
Yes, that's where I mentioned how we profile with the use of a message header and a message history. So we implemented that in every message type we have in Denmark.
Should I quickly replay the last 2 minutes and 30 seconds? So you have the slides with the audio, or do you want to go through them verbally?
I think it's fine for now that if you show this one and people are free to ask if they have questions about how we chose to profile these two message types. For us, it's very important that we have this provenance resource, which we use to combine an actual message with a prior message. If you receive a message and you need to send it forward to a third organization, we use the provenance resources to combine a number of messages. And that could be profiled in other methods in other countries, for instance. So that would be nice to have comments on that if we are on the right path on that.
All right. I got two questions. First one is, yeah, please, could you give us a link where we could access these Danish messages? Can you provide them later in the Q&A part?
Yes, if you take another to page 8, if you take the this is the care communication, and here the page 9 is about. I thought it was a link inside. I'm sorry.
Oh, but you can provide it later in the chat.
Yeah.
All right, we'll make sure that it gets there.
Yeah. Could you see the last page in the presentation? Yeah, yes, actually, I prepared two questions for myself.
Okay.
Which is
there's one more question as well.
Yeah.
Sorry. One question is, does either of the Danish IGs include any operation definitions?
What do you mean about operations? There's no information about the clinical operations, if that's the question. But because we have two types of messages, but they don't hold any information about diagnosis or about procedures. But perhaps I misunderstand the question.
I will read it one more time then. Does either of the Danish IGs include any operation definitions?
The answer is no if it is operations from a FHIR server, because we implement them only for a messaging, so we message them in an envelope instead. But that is something we will. The Danish infrastructure is a messaging infrastructure still, But when we established a national database where we store these in a FHIR server, the next step will be enabling it with some FHIR services. And there we would need some operations for fetching or retrieving different types of data. But that's not our first step. We don't implement that this year. But it would be naturally to implement that afterwards.
All right. Somebody elaborated on that as well. Then there is another question that is extra to this one. What is the underlying transport you're using for message transfer in Denmark? What is
it? Well, if we talk about message transfer, it's about the transportation of the message, as I hear the question.
Yes.
Where we have right now we have a privately operated network. And we want to implement this new European infrastructure because it's an open market. Everyone can implement as an access point in this e-delivery network. So it's implemented in healthcare in Denmark, but also in many other domains within the public Denmark. And I know that many other member states in the European Union also start to implement this new messaging network. It gives a great benefit that you can send healthcare messages in the same technology as you send invoicing, for instance.
All right. That's for now the different questions that came in. Do you want to elaborate on your own questions?
Well, my first elaboration was that that's very hard to be a front runner and implement a lot of things during 25 years. So it's very hard to change very many systems. But we'll try to see how many years does it take to migrate. Can we do this in 2 years? Can we do it in 4 years? How long is that going to make a transition into FHIR? But we try to push as hard we can to make it as fast as possible, this transition. But it's a difficult maneuver.
All right. We have 2 minutes left. There are not yet any new questions apart from the ones that you answered. The link is provided right now. It can be found in the chat if everyone is wondering, or in the question. There's a new one. Sorry. Did you take into the consideration messages definition as well?
We have a sort of definition for all the messages. For instance, they all have a message header and a message history. And the message history contains the provenance resource. So that's a unique decision we made. Each message type will be exactly the same. But we in our profiling, we chose to make a individual message header profiling for each message type. So the focus in each message header is one and only exactly one message type. And that was a choice we made, but otherwise we have no fixed plan which resources to use in which message types. It depends upon the message itself, what kind of data you will exchange. If it's reimbursements or it's discharge letters, they could be very different.
All right. We ran out of time, so that's good. If there are any more questions, please feel free to keep asking them. Michael is able to answer them later in the question and answer section. Then it only left me to thank you very much for your presentation and your time.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.